Hey, I'm Keith with Botron, and today I'll be taking you through my process for performing preventative maintenance on ionizers and how you can keep yours running tip-top. An ionizer isn't a cheap piece of equipment, so you don't want to neglect them. Additionally, their main purpose is to protect your assemblies. So if they aren't performing as they should be, well, you might have a bigger problem. My goal here is to help you avoid that by sharing my process with you step by step. Now for this video, we'll be using the Botron Intelligent Ionizer. These come in different form factors, from benchtop to overhead, with a single fan on up to three. The components we'll be looking at and taking into consideration today are the filters, grills, emitter pins, and fans. All of these are subject to dirt, dust, oil, and grime. As debris accumulates over time, it can impair the performance or even damage your ionizer. And that brings me to tip number one, define a thorough qualification process. Too often, people are not fully qualifying their ionizers. More specifically, they're not capturing all metrics. What I mean by this is when we do qualifications, it's not uncommon for that to take place in the most ideal state. Don't gloss over qualifying your ionizers under real-world conditions. When you're doing your qualifications, you shouldn't only be looking at discharge times, you should observe the performance over time. Checking the filters, emitter pins, fans, and grills on occasion, and just let it run. If your qualification period isn't long enough, make sure you track this in the very first months after you buy and do your install. This will give you a good gauge to set your cleaning interval. This brings us to tip number two, set a cleaning schedule. Don't be reactive. Don't wait for the ionizer to fail or when you do periodic verifications, because that's often too late. Chances are the ionizer has been overworked, the fan motors are stressed, debris is blowing onto your assemblies, and it's out of balance. All no-nos that could impact your product in the performance of your ionizer. Too often, this is dictated by a prefixed schedule of periodic verification, and it should be the opposite. Periodic verification should be defined by your environmental factors. So how do we set that schedule? What you want to do here is take the data you've collected from your qualification process in your production environment and use it to define a reasonable limit of imbalance, such as 30 volts. An ionizer, like the one we have here, has a built-in continuous monitor, and it verifies ion balance continuously. It allows you to dial in a voltage limit, so if we set it to something like 30 volts, well, when the ionizer reaches a state of 30 volts or above, it will alarm and alert the person at the bench. This helps you automate a big part of the cost of ownership by eliminating your need to do random or routine checks. But if you don't have an ionizer like this, what should your schedule look like? Well, this can be different for each fab, even each production line. If you have a lot of oil in the air, smoke, and metals, say from soldering, you'll want to clean that more regularly. Now, what about self-cleaning ionizers? Does this mean you never have to clean them? No, they still need to be cleaned regularly. A self-cleaning ionizer typically has a brush built into the axle of the fan. This brush runs across the emitter pins when you power down and power up the ionizer. If you run your ionizers 24/7, the brushes aren't helping. While self-cleaning is certainly a nice-to-have feature, it's not set it and forget it. You'll want to make sure that your operators are turning the ionizer off and on at the beginning of each shift. In all, the combination of self-cleaning and ion balance monitoring can drastically cut back your resources and time you allocate to maintenance. Tip number three, clean all the components. I've seen this many times, pins, filters, but not fans and grills, or just filters. My recommendation, don't cut any corners. So when you clean the entire thing. Grime on the emitter pins is the easiest way to throw your ionizer out of balance. Clogged filters, well, that's a sure way to move less ions. Dusty grills and fans, those not only will blow debris on your assemblies, but it impacts the signal from the continuous monitor. Additionally, this could cause your fan to seize, and generally, it reduces the amount of ions coming out of the ionizer. You're always going to want to use the right tools and cleaning agents to prolong the life of your ionizer. You could use canned air or an air gun to blow off grills and fans, but it might be better to vacuum them using an ESD-safe vacuum attachment. As for filters, you can bang them out in a trash can or behind the fab, but compressed air works really well. Some filters are washable, but this will increase your downtime when you're doing your maintenance. For the emitter pins, use non-corrosive, non-residue cleaning agents. This will differ depending on the metal composition of the emitter pin. Some metal compositions react with air and create a natural layer of corrosion resistance. Cleaners that leave behind a residue not only will create pitting, but also impact the ionizer's ability to charge the air. IPA is usually a safe choice, but do some research on the metal type used in your ionizer. That brings us to our final and probably best tip of the bunch. In combination with these other pointers, what you'll want to do is identify who's going to clean the ionizers. If you have 10, well, that's just a one-person job. But when you have hundreds of ionizers, that's just not possible. In fact, even if you have a team of people, it's incredibly costly and resource-heavy. The best approach to this problem is to train the operators at the bench on how to clean their ionizers. Some components are less sensitive than others. If you're not comfortable with the operator cleaning the interior components, share some of the responsibility between the operator and your technicians. The idea is to get through the process as thoroughly and quickly as possible. So in summary, keeping your ionizers clean is really important. They're costly devices, but the impacts of ill-performing ionizers could be even greater. To increase the efficiency of your maintenance tasks, make it a team effort. Ionizers like the one here from Botron with built-in continuous monitoring will put you ahead of the game. Self-cleaning ionizers. When used to its advantage, when the operator at the bench cycles power regularly, they not only will help you keep the emitter points cleaner for a longer period of time, but extend the lifetime of your ionizer. Lastly, take the time to qualify your ionizers in the production environment. Monitor and measure its performance over time. Use this to set a schedule of what to clean and when. And remember, your environment will dictate how often your ionizer will need to be cleaned. What somebody else is doing doesn't mean it will work for you and your facility. Now these tips, they're more about how to properly care for your ionizer, keeping them running at peak performance, reducing overhead, and increasing uptime, and to help you define an efficient maintenance program. Thank you for watching. My hope is that you find this video helpful. If you have any additional tips or pointers, drop a comment below for our future viewers. I'm Keith, and I'll see you next time.